The complex network transformation initiatives being undertaken by CSPs are leading to the creation of more efficient operational processes and the launch of innovative new services. We've already seen some significant advancements that are positively impacting the communications industry, with more still to come. Well, to discuss how telco transformation is powering network and service innovation, I'm joined by Kit Colbert, who is Chief Technology Officer for VMware. Kit, very good to see you again. Now, this transformation of the telco industry has been well underway for some time now. In your role as a CTO, you get many opportunities to invent. So what do you think are some of the most significant advancements which have made their way into the market and are having a real impact on the communications industry?
Yeah, well, first of all, thanks for having me. Always great to be here. And you're absolutely right. It's been really interesting watching all these advances. And in fact, I think one of the really interesting things is sort of how we're seeing the communications industry have the quote-unquote iPhone moment, which, you know, we talk about in the sense of how you start looking at mobile devices starting to take a lot of those technologies coming from the IT and the data center side, things like mature operating systems and so forth, and kind of this open standard, and, you know, starting to build that into their own systems. And I think we're starting to see this now, particularly with the advent of cloud. And so all of the lessons that we've learned as an IT industry, we can start applying into the CSP space. And you've seen that, right? This notion of leveraging virtualization, the move now toward containerization, toward to re-architecting to cloud native. And I think, you know, you look at the RAN in particular, and that's a really interesting one, this notion of specialized hardware and software tightly integrated, but now moving to virtualized RAN and getting some of that separation. And finally, moving toward open RAN, where we can really get true disaggregation between hardware and software. A lot more innovation starting to come in there. So I think, again, what we're seeing are these practices that have played out well in the cloud space that we can now start bringing to bear within the CSP industry.
Now, managing this transformation presents many challenges for CSPs. It can be a very difficult process. So how do you work with your CSP partners to help with their transformation process and also to mitigate risks, both on the technological side and also the operational side?
Yeah, that's a great question. And, you know, transformation is really core to what we do at VMware, right? We've been doing that with customers and partners for the past two decades or so. And particularly as we talk about the shift into cloud computing, into the cloud sort of the mindset and operational model, that is a really big shift. And, you know, as I talked about, the core of cloud computing really is virtualization. It's the underlying technology that separates hardware from software, that allows you to start modeling things within software, that enables things like automation and governance via APIs and software. And so this is radically efficient and can drive tremendous changes in operations. And the benefits there are, you know, very visible to anyone who looks. But as you mentioned, there's challenges in getting there, right? And so, first things first, I think some people, partners, when they look, they say, hey, we need best performance we can possibly get. And we're a little worried, does virtualization add any overhead? Well, certainly 20 years ago, when we first got started, it did. But today, through much of the innovation that we've done ourselves, as well as that with our hardware partners, you know, folks like Intel and other processor vendors, we've dramatically reduced that overhead, essentially to zero now. You look at performance of virtualization, it's as fast, or sometimes even faster, than bare metal systems, which I know can be kind of surprising. But we really had a maniacal focus there on optimization. So you have that core foundation. And on top of that, it's really around building in all these other great capabilities of cloud and packaging that up for our CSP partners to be able to take advantage of. I talked about this notion of open RAN, the ability to really open up innovation, to allow new folks to come in and start innovating as well. And so, you know, a great example of that is a partner of ours called Cohere. Now, what they're really focused on is spectrum efficiency, and they've actually been able to increase that by 50%. But that's only possible because of this open architecture. And we can actually make it really easy for our CSP partners to consume that innovation through the packaging that we do here at VMware. The final thing I'll mention, because you mentioned risk. And so I do want to talk about security, because that is a really key focus. And, you know, when we talk about virtualization, security there is really built in from the beginning. It's all about clean isolation between virtualization tenants, right? And that's been core to the architecture. But we continue to build on top of that. So you look at some of the security operations capabilities that we have, the ability to respond to security events. And more recently, a real focus on the secure software supply chain, this notion of ensuring that everything that's running in your environment has been fully vetted and that hackers have not had an opportunity to get in there and potentially, you know, poison the water or the well there. So end to end, it's all about providing the key building blocks to accelerate the CSP partners' transformation into the modern future.
And Kit, this transformation, we all know it's necessary for the creation and deployment of new applications and services for CSPs and their customers. And many of these services are going to require that performance boost you just mentioned and spoke about. Of all these new services you get to research and innovate around, what are some of the most promising ones that you can share with us?
Yeah, well, there's a ton of exciting things happening. It's probably too many of the list. But let me start with one here. And the idea, you know, you look at the Open RAN, again, this notion of disaggregation of software and hardware, of opening that up to a tremendous amount of innovation across the industry, and even folks coming from outside the industry. And we want to do that not just for the RAN, but in fact, for the overall, the entire grid. And so there's an effort we're driving along amongst with many partners called the Open Grid Alliance. And the basic concept there is, how do we take that same sort of disaggregation, that same sort of opening up the space for innovation, but doing so now for the entire grid, really rethinking how the grid needs to be designed and architected to support 5G and next G. The number of new devices, the amount of speed that we're going to need to support, and in fact, increasing the intelligence in the network. You see so many applications today or even companies that are built around the fact that these networks don't have a lot of that extra metadata. And so you have to do a lot of the work sort of on top of the network, so to speak. But this is all about making the network smarter, building in that so you can actually have that extra information and do those optimizations and extra functionality directly there in the network. The other thing I'll mention really quickly that actually builds on this is this notion of spatial computing. So what this is really about is taking the digital twin concept, right? The notion of replicating something in the physical world and the software world. And this has happened for a while. We see it with CAD and in many different, you know, manufacturing, engineering type use cases. But now what we can start to do with the advent of IoT, with the advent of 5G, with all these extra sensors out there, is get a lot more real-time information, not about just these, you know, single individual things, but with a much richer perspective of the real world that includes people and moving things and, you know, things that are in motion, I should say, and all sorts of other stuff. And so the applications of spatial computing are extraordinarily broad, crossing, you know, things like we have to like fun with, like gaming, to more important and serious things like, you know, the healthcare industry, or even, you know, significantly advancing manufacturing. So these are just a couple of the exciting things that are on the precipice as we start to rethink the underlying architecture and drive toward what, as I mentioned before, that modern future.
Well, as you say, it is all exciting. There's a lot of applications and services coming through there. Now, creating new revenue streams is obviously a top priority for service providers around the world. Can you tell us more about some of those services that you've watched CSPs bring to market recently, ones that have really grabbed your attention?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And I think that is the big opportunity here. As I said, with things like the Open Grid Alliance, or even what we're seeing with Open RAN, we can fundamentally make the network more intelligent. And what that does is provide a tremendous number of opportunities for players in the space. And so, you know, we're seeing innovations across the board. I'm really excited about what Dish is doing, getting into their 5G rollout, really rethinking, again, that overall network architecture to be able to deliver a lot of differentiated services. You know, we talked about this notion of digital twin, of spatial computing, the ability to like put on the VR headset and actually be somewhere else, right? Not just the sort of theoretical static version of it, but the real life version. And so we're seeing that in different scenarios. NTT is driving a whole bunch of virtual reality there. Who else? KDDI, you know, is doing a whole bunch of interactive experiences based around this. You look at Telefonica and their digital twin focus on manufacturing. So again, you start seeing this opportunity of these IoT devices out there, the ability to bring that in real time for the network to be able to support that, to have the extra intelligence there. But in the end, it's about providing a better experience for users, something truly differentiated that they're unable to do today and that the CSPs can uniquely enable. So that's really what this is all about. And I think that the opportunities are limitless and we've just started scratching the surface, but it is truly exciting.
Yeah, those are great examples, and we hope to see more like these launch as CSPs innovate with their partners and continue their network transformation initiatives. Kit, for now, thanks very much for joining us today and sharing your views and insights.
Thanks so much for having me.